So cleaning up the mass airflow sensor did seem to give me a little bit more oomph. The car seemed to run smoother and all that kind of stuff, but it still sounds pretty horrible. And because I'm waiting for all the parts to do the full tune-up, I think it's time to assess the actual condition of the engine. It does have 111,000 miles. Now, these M30 engines, which is what is in this BMW, they're bulletproof on the bottom end, and they can easily last 250,000 miles if they're maintained properly. Of course, the problem is, I don't have a clue how this car was maintained.
And it's
And it certainly doesn't sound like it was maintained super well, even though the body is in incredible condition. One of the things that's involved with regular maintenance on this engine is a lash adjustment. And if you don't do it, the engine does all this ticking and makes all kinds of noise. And there are actually a couple of things under the valve cover that can go wrong on this car and cause all kinds of problems. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and take the valve cover off. We're gonna do that lash adjustment, and I'm gonna walk you through how to do it just in case you end up with an M30 engine. And we're gonna see if we can make this thing run smoother. And then when the rest of the parts show up this week to get the vacuum system all squared away and new plugs and new wires and all that kind of stuff, well, then we'll really have everything set to run this car. Let's jump into this lash adjustment thing. Now, I've never actually done it on an E30 before. We'll be learning together. So let's do this. Now, the last thing I want to do is blow this out so that if anything is in here or around the edges, it doesn't fall into the engine. So let's quickly do that. That ought to do it. And let's take the spark plugs out here. I want to do a compression test. So this right here is not the right socket size for these plugs, which I'm used to working on American cars. What are you gonna do? But BMW includes this nifty tool right here. So we're gonna use that. Not bad. Not new by any stretch of the imagination, but not bad. Again, not too bad. Smell a lot of gas though. A lot of gas. Definitely leads me to believe that some of these are not firing. That one looks like it's working pretty hard. Well, there we go. Got all the plugs out. Now let's do a little bit of a compression test and see how healthy this engine is. One of the cool things about this M30 engine is this little port right here. Now, it doesn't have any OBD port or anything, so you can actually check the health of the engine. It's too old for that. But this thing actually gives you the ability to do some really cool stuff without having to sit in the seat and control the car. This has ports numbered on it. Each of these little ports is connected to different aspects of the car. And in this case, port 11 is the battery, and port 14 is the starter, which means I can turn the car over to check the compression without having to sit in the driver's seat or disconnect any of the fuel stuff, because it's just the starter. That's all it does. So I rigged up this nifty little button right here. When I hold down the button, it will use the starter to turn the car over. When I let it go, it stops. We're gonna hook that up now and test the compression. Of course, this is mirrored. So if I put it on and then I take it off, it doesn't actually line up. It also has the numbers written on here as well, just in case you get a little bit confused. This is 11 here. And this right here is 14. And there we go. Now when we push the button, there we go. So let's see what happens when we do this compression test. All right, let's see what happens here. So we've got about 138 there on the first cylinder. Wrote it down. Let's move on to the next. Well, that's not good. Definitely not good. About 195. We're about 95 actually. All right, on to the next. And that's got about 95 as well. Huh. Maybe 103, 104. That one's closer to 110, about maybe 108. Right around 95 to 100, right below 100. So it would seem that this cylinder, cylinder one, is the outliner, or the outlier. All right, so looking at these numbers right here for our compression, admittedly, I was a little bit bummed out because it does seem that maybe our engine has more problems than we think. But these engines required maintenance on the top end that may have never actually happened on this car. And there is an encouraging sign here. Cylinder number one had 138 psi of pressure in there, and that's pretty close to normal. Whereas the rest of them were consistently low, but there's not one cylinder here that's just not getting compression or anything. All of the compression in the other cylinders is pretty close to within 10%. So that means that they do hold compression. There's just possibly some problems with the valve seats or maybe the timing. And I'm thinking it's possible that the valve lashes are so out of adjustment that even when the cylinder is in top dead center, it's keeping those valves open, which means we've got compression escaping. So let's actually go through and do those valve lash adjustments and see if it will fix our compression problem, because I know they need to be adjusted. I can hear them. So let's give it a shot. Overall, everything in here looks very, very clean and almost like it's new. Now, this banjo bolt was loose. Not a huge shock. These things will back themselves out, and we're gonna fix that problem. There's no sludge, there's no buildup. Everything is oiled. The camshaft does not appear to be in any kind of funky shape. It's clean and it's smooth. Everything on this end looks pretty good. Could mean that our compression problems are not what I'm hoping they are. I don't know, this engine looks really clean, so. We'll see. I know if you're watching this, you love cars, and making this sort of content is definitely a labor of love. So if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have a moment, leave a comment down below. Let me know how I'm doing. This really helps the algorithm push this video to a wider audience. And if you're not subscribed, please do. It really helps me continue to make this sort of content, and I do appreciate it. So thanks. So in order for you to do this adjustment, it's between 12 and 14 on the feeler gauge. And you can see I got this nifty curved one, which theoretically should fit right in there around the stuff. Now, I'm gonna start with the first cylinder here, and we're gonna move all the way down. This is actually number one cylinder, and I don't know what the firing order is, but I think this is two, and this is three, and that's four, so however it goes. Either way, we're gonna start here. We're gonna move our way back. You wanna do it with the piston all the way up in the top dead center position. In order to crank the engine, we're gonna use this little trick here again, and you can usually do this pretty easily. Now you're gonna need a hex nut, a little tiny one. It has to fit into a little hole right here. And we also need a 10 mil. So let's just get this engine where we need to be. And that looks about right. That looks exactly like where we want it to be. No, really close. These two lobes have to be in their lowest position. And it looks pretty close. Nope. We were right the first time. And we missed it again. There we are. So what we do is we just loosen up our 10 millimeter here. Avoid stripping these, if at all possible. Let's get some more light down here. Just loosen these up. And then we want to be able to adjust where they're at with this. And we're gonna stick our little gauge in there. And just be able to feel the resistance. And then once you get it so it's right, just go ahead and tighten it up. You don't need a lot of torque on these. And there we go. Let's take a look at this one. Tighten it back up. One down. Five more to go. Two down, four to go. In the grieving process, one of the first stages is denial. And love of car ownership, especially if you're going to deal with old beaters like this, well, that's one of the first stages too. So the writing is on the wall. We have some compression problems, but at this point, I have not yet accepted those facts and looked at the actual empirical evidence. So we did get to see the compression test on this car, and then the lash adjustment, which is a great thing to learn how to do on these cars, but really wishful thinking, if I'm being honest. So in the next video, we're really gonna find out about the condition of this engine once and for all. And we're probably going to have to accept the cold hard facts here. My name is Michael Fire Jr. and this is For the Love of Cars. There is no other reason why I would be doing this. And I know you're watching because you love cars too. So go out and drive your car. Have a great day. And I'll see you in the next one.